Artificial intelligence is all over the place. There's lots of different applications using it, some using it in much more complex ways than others. In today's video, I'm going to give you 5 examples of how they're currently being used in productivity tools and digging a little bit deeper into that, into maybe which artificial intelligence is best for you right now. So before we begin, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. If you're new here, please do subscribe. It'd be great to have you. We talk about lots of productivity tools and resources. And if you fancy checking out more AI-based productivity tools, you can find them over on Toolfinder. That'll be linked in the description below. So there are 5 good examples embedded in productivity tools, and it centers around something called Gen AI, essentially generative AI, ones that are gonna produce an output for you. So let's look at our first one. Our first one is Craft. Now, Craft have the AI embedded in their editor. Essentially, you could press slash command and up pops assistant, it's called. And essentially, you can use it to spout out text, maybe translate a section that you've selected, or edit and modify what you've got. And it comes as part of different plans. So currently, Craft have a few plans and pricing options around this use of artificial intelligence. But for example, in the business plan, you get 1,000 uses per month, and that renews monthly. Now you can find out more about this below, but currently Craft's example of artificial intelligence is probably one of more primitive examples of it, and probably compares most likely to Notion. But let's talk a little bit about the second example of AI, Notion AI. Right now, Notion are doing very similar to what Craft are doing. You can use a slash command to help you write, summarize, use bullet points, translate, edit, modify, write a poem. There are so many options to what you can do, and obviously you can take advantage of the ChatGPT prompts and the general prompts out there to really go a lot further. However, inside Notion AI, they're using a few different blocks that are a little bit more progressive. For example, they've got a new content block that allows you to add that block in and summarize particular parts of text, but for everyone in the team, which is pretty helpful. You can also do that with extracting actions across a whole document, and also maybe using recommendations on things that need to be done. But what's interesting is it brings in people. For example, if I use the action items list, I could bring in people like I'm working with in the team. And it's quite helpful for being able to summarize a page in quick succession. So Notion's AI is rapidly developing and improving. So it's interesting to see this grow out. Moving on to the next one, Mem is doing a little bit differently. Now, before we begin this section, I am an investor in Mem. If you'd like to find out more about how that works, you can find the link in description to how we operate with that. So Mem does stuff slightly differently, because what it does, it takes all of your existing notes that are inside a Mem or your Mems and essentially combines that with the GPT-3 system, allowing you to get more advanced recommendations. So what it will do is before it spouts out information, it'll go to the source of what you've typed into your Mems in the past. So for example, if I asked it, what are 5 ways that I could advance my business by £10,000, something like that, then what'll happen is it'll use everything I've added into Mem, not just stuff that's on the web, and combine it with that to produce an output. So a very interesting approach by taking some of the knowledge that you have inside of your experience already. Moving on to the next one, number 4, Qatalog are probably doing something very interesting in the productivity space. What they're doing is essentially allowing you to create a workspace from scratch using this generative AI technology. So for example, if you wanted to go ahead and type in, I want to create a marketing agency structure for my new Qatalog account, it'll build it for you, essentially using objects and structures that are built from generative AI. So a really interesting approach to structural AI, but maybe not fully there of what I would expect structural AI to be like. But it definitely helps to build a layer to your account so that you can build from that. So a very interesting take, maybe the death of templates in the future, but a very interesting take they have at the moment. Finally, the fifth example is Todoist. Now, Todoist have a very good setup with AI at the moment. You can use your AI assistant to improve three aspects of your task. You can make your task more actionable by giving it a stronger title. You can give recommendations on how to complete your task with some tips from the AI, and you can even use your you can use it essentially to recommend you subtasks to complete that task. So if you added something like bake a, new flapjack, then it can recommend you some steps to produce and get to that goal. So there's an interesting approach to this one. I think this one is probably the best example, and that's why I'm leaving it for last, of the optimization, because it really truly understands what a task is and it's giving more relevant output, in my opinion, to helping you to complete the task. Now, in the future, there's lots more examples of how this works, and the lists are endless. We're going to do a few more videos on this in the near future. But if you're interested in some of the AI tools that I've mentioned, or a few of them more, you can find them fully listed below on Toolfinder. Thank you very much for stopping by, folks, today. I hope you enjoyed today's feature, and I hope to see you in a future video. Cheerio!